Right, I've got a confession on this one, is that I haven't ever built a hex beam. I've spoken to plenty of people that have got a hex beam, and I'm about to sneeze. Oh, no, I didn't. All right, so that was handy. So what is your hex beam? Well, we can go on the internet. It's a lot easier than me drawing it out, actually. But, I mean, we'll use this in a minute for something else. Hex beam antenna. Just make sure everything is recording. It is, and we'll go to the images. That's the easiest one. It's a big hex beam there. Now, it looks funny. Well, it doesn't look funny. It's not like funny hilarious. But you can see pictures of this thing. I mean, because I've modelled one as well, and you'd be able to have a look at it too. So effectively, what it is you've got this centre post. We'll look straight down on it, like a bird's eye view. You've got this centre post, and then we have these spreaders that are about 3.25 metres each side, so about 6.5 metres in total length. All right. I'm not quite sure how good I'm drawing this. I need a bit of graph paper or something. Okay, that'll do. So which way are we facing? It's going to face that way, all right? And then these are fiberglass spreaders, and they're held under tension, these spreaders, by all the wires, because we can then put, right, there's one SO239 connection at the bottom. I mean, the original hex beam had little sections of coax, but some manufacturers have now got a tube and they've drilled it out and done really cool stuff. But you go and buy one or whatever else. What I'm interested in is the basic construction and how well it works. And that's what we're going to do. Right, just interrupt the flow because I'm editing this right now. Obviously, most hex beams are multi-band. What they have is more than one element. I'm just going to draw and describe one element, and that's the 20-meter band. But they'll work the same on all of these. All right, let's get back to it. Now, there's been a couple of iterations. The very first iteration of the hex beam had, we'll use a light purple, had something like, I think it was nothing like that at all. There, that's it, not this bit. So that M, and there was a kind of a W here, all right? That was the first one. However, I think it was G3THQ. Somebody did some research and felt that actually it'd be better to make it a bit bigger and do this and then bring that all the way around the back. And then you get the separation, you see, some separation between here and here. Hex beam. Right, so get that away a minute because I've drawn one in software. I drew the wires out and then deleted effectively the struts. And that's it, just drawn almost from memory, if you know what I mean. I optimized it roughly to this. And basically it kind of works, X, Y. There's a couple of mistakes in the optimization. Is this should be down there and that should be roughly there. Imagining it was just a piece of wire, because you get one element. If you buy it from a manufacturer, you shouldn't have to do anything. You just string it up. Clip it together and it's dying, you see. Anyway, just leave it as optimized at the minute because I haven't drawn it that accurately. I was just having some fun last night and thought, oh, that's looked quite interesting. I'll show the people back home, you see. So we can calculate at 14.2. And now is the height. How high do you want this thing, right? So let's start off, in my opinion, if you're going to go to the extent of having some sort of Yagi, I reckon 12 metres, 40-ish feet, is great because it's more than half a wavelength on the 20-metre band. Now, this is my optimised. You know, real hex beam might be slightly different. But we look at the far field plot, looks quite nice. And if you remember, a single vertical, just with a half-decent ground, at 5 degrees off the horizon, will give us about minus 5-ish dBi at 5 degrees. So I've told this it's 5 degrees and it says 1.5 dBi. So that's 7.5 dB better at 40 feet, 12.5 meters. And that is worthwhile writing home about because not only have you got gain there, is you've got fantastic front to back. So for us in the UK, we got the Germans, the Italians and the Russians behind us and we're trying to make contact to the USA. I can dial him back by minus 14, you know, dB. It's tremendous, all right? However, that's at 12 meters, 40-ish feet. Now, a lot of us can't do that, right? We've got to come down a bit, all right? So if you just take 2 meters off that and do 10 meters now, and we'll hit the start button, and we'll go at 5 degrees off the horizon. How well is that going to do? It's on 20 meters, by the way. Only 20 meters. Now we're at minus 0.5. So we're about 4 to 5 dB better than a straight vertical, for instance. And I've got a comparison video, what's best, dipole versus vertical and stuff. If you watch all these, you'll be able to piece together, right? Because I'm not going to do a one-hour presentation for you about all these different things. But anyway, I mean, I would still say that would be worthwhile at 30-something feet or 10 metres. Now, Tom runs his, I think it's 7 metres off the ground. And he says sometimes the DX Commander's better, sometimes the Hex Beam's better. So it's quite interesting, actually, because at 5 degrees off the horizon, it says minus 3.8. Well, he's absolutely right, because his DX Commander will be giving him about minus 4.5. So there's negligible difference between the two. So that's quite interesting. Now then, that's on 20 meters. And the reason I said that is that each time you go up a band, relatively speaking, as a percentage of the wavelength, you've gone higher, right? So let's say you're on the 20 meter band here, but you flick up to 10 meters, all right, you've effectively now doubled the height of your hex beam off the floor, all right? You just have, because you're now a whole wavelength above the ground, whereas before you were a half a wavelength. So rather than recalculating all this, we can just say, we'll just increase the height. We'll double it for 28 megahertz, and we'll start that, and we will see 10 meter band, we've got much better gain now, 5.1, because it's a lot easier to get gain when you're proportionally further off the deck, all right? Because a hex beam won't just come with one element. You'll get at least three, all right? If not six, it'll do all of them. And it looks and acts and feels like a two-element Yagi. Slightly, maybe there's a half a dB in it. There's not a lot. You know, a two-element Yagi, like an Opti beam or maybe a step IR, two-element step IR. There's not a lot in it, actually, a hex beam and this. In fact, I'll prove it to you. Let's go back to, say, 10 metres off the ground. And this is 4-hour hex, isn't it? Yeah, it's a funny old hex, but whatever else. And we'll do 5 degrees, just roughly, just so we're baselining everything at 5. Could be 7, 3, doesn't matter. And I'll fire another instance. I can't spell. Another instance of this off, because I also got airways here as a two-element Yagi, and I just happen to remember it's at 14.05 real ground, so we'll do 10 meters again, the same stuff. Make it out of wire, you know, just compare apples with apples. Ignore the SWR, I mean, it's the far field plot I'm after. Now, I got no idea, this looks funny plot to me, so this probably needs some optimization. Forward gain's probably fairly accurate, though. So let's have a look at the forward gain. 0.2, the hex beam says minus a half. So it's slightly more gain. We could probably press some buttons here and actually tidy this Yagi up using the optimization button, which I'm not going to do now. Well, that's the middle of the day. But there we are. That's what hex beam is. What would I say? If you can't do it, if you can't get to 10 meters, it's a hell of a lot of investment to put in, right, without getting to 10 meters. If you get to 40 feet, if you get to 12 and a half meters, I think you will be absolutely flying. Tim, M0URX, I think he runs his most of the time on 10 metres, about 10 metres high. Because in the UK, there is like 10 MRs. There's a few companies that will do quite an economical 10 metre kit, if you know what I mean. You can bolt to the side of your house. In America, I know you can go 60 foot, you know, fairly economically. But then you've got to factor in your tower, your extra coax, and a half-decent rotator. And have a gang of people every now and that you can rely on every now and again, come and see you to help you have a little maintenance party, you know, once a year or something. All right. So it's a big investment. That's all I'm saying. So make sure you know that's what you want to do. Fantastic toy. All right. But if the wind blows and the storm comes up, then I can sleep at night because I don't have one of these. All right, good luck to you. That's it for the time being. I think my dinner's ready. I will see you on the next one. All the best now. Bye for now.